What's up, guys? This is Hadai at 7 RCT Gaming, bringing you the first video, the first one of 2022. I'm kind of pumped. I'm kind of psyched. I hope you guys are doing well, staying safe and healthy, and getting better as time goes on. We are living in a crazy, crazy world, but we can push through. I have no doubts. It only takes a little bit of time. But that out of the way, as you can see by the background, yes, I'm going to talk about Core Type R. What the hell is Core Type R, you ask? Well, simple. It's just a creation, a long time being made, being worked on, tinkered on. I can call and point out the three single most responsible for this. Nice little build that you're going to see here is actually Player One Channel 3. You guys know him. Doesn't need a lot of introduction. I've covered him in the past. Stainless as well. And Signum as well. All three I've done videos in the past, either covering a pack that they have made or a build or anything. And I love me this stuff and I love to be part of the community. But to be completely honest, the back end of 2021 was kind of sluggish and kind of slow with everything going on. And these guys, they got together, said, you know, enough is enough. You know, we need something. We need to inject with, you know, Core specifically. We need to inject some life into this thing. And they came up with this that you're about to see here. Now, let me start by showing you how it looks, what it is, and what it has different from the Core that you know and love for quite a while now. And you're going to see where the Type R comes into Core here. Now, first I need to say, before I get too deep into it, I'm going to mention that a lot of the stuff that you see here, if not all of the stuff that you see here, has been either remade, redone, adjusted, you know, tweaked and made so it's as visually pleasing as possible. Now, you guys know already what core builds are made with RetroFE and all that good stuff. If you don't, and you're new to the channel and new to the content that I usually post, go back, check a few of my playlists, and you will get up to snuff. But as far as this is concerned, let me see if I can walk you through it. Usually I showcase by just moving around menus and playing a few games here and there, but I'm going to try to explain to you how awesome this thing is by going in detail by detail. Hopefully the video is not going to drag too long. If so, I'm sorry, but this is kind of worth it. All right. So first off, you're seeing right here, basically two options, have MAME and Triforce. Also, I want to mention, before I go into the deeper aspects of it, is that many, many, many packs are being made as I film this. They are almost ready to release, so they should come out soon after this build, the main one, or the base Type R is released, okay? So that said, let's get into this a bit better. Here we have basically Triforce and MAME. Everything you're going to be controlling A and B. In order to call up the menu, you press B here once, and you're going to see the usual Titan menu where you have several options. You have, of course, you have the arcade, which is where we were at. You have collections. We have computers, we have console, we have handhelds, and we have settings. Now, in the past, Player One Channel 3, and he is a stickler for detail, I've been trying to keep up as he, because it's basically an evolution. You know, ever since he came out with his Atlas theme and his Titan theme, he's kept adding and adding and making it even more like prettier and useful at the same time, because what's the use of having beauty without any, you know, any context, any heft to it? You know what I'm saying? Instead of being a shallow thing that might be pretty, but in the long run, it gets stale, it gets boring. Not here, my friends. If you go into settings, and let's say you want to switch things up, in the settings, you're going to find the first option, which is bezels and shaders. Now, bezels and shaders is a simple option. You have the standard bezel, which is the normal one that you would see in your classic console. But also, you have night bezels. Now, this is a variant shaded in a way that it gives the impression that you're playing in the dark. Or during nighttime. So the colors are a little bit more subdued, which is awesome, I gotta say, because I usually like to play in the dark in my studio space. I don't like to have a lot of lights on and just keep my monitor. So this is kind of more subtle in case you don't want all that, you know, brightness going on into your eyes. So that said, let's get out of here. And actually, let me select it so you guys can see it. Once you select it, it goes back. It doesn't take you out of the build itself. It restarts. And now when you go into the game, those bezels are going to be there. So pay attention, stay alert. When I go into a game, you're going to see them. But in terms of changes, let's say I don't want to use this style. And here are the options that you have from the settings. If I had a simple way of explaining it, it would be that you have, he divided, player one, channel three, divided this basically, the visual aspect of this build into two components. One would be the outer menu, or the menu that where you select the systems, the consoles, the handhelds, all that stuff. You have a menu that specifically is going to target that. And then you have the other secondary menu, which is the one where you select the game. Now, if you go into Titan settings, right now, I have the wheel menu, right? That's what you see me using. And the wheel menu, and I have it, the secondary would be the spin. So that's why you see that kind of hyper-spinish kind of look to it, the one that we've known for ages. But let's mix it up. Let's change to the Titan menu. Select it here. Let it go through the motion. And then from here, I'm going to go into settings again. And now that we've picked basically the primary menu or the system menu, let's change how we, you know, view the games by selecting then, let's do gallery. This one right here. So we're going to select gallery. And now we're supposed to have the combination of Titan menu and gallery menu. Now let's see if I am correct. We have our Titan menu. Everything is showing up here. Let's select consoles. And once we go into a console, you see here that I have the gallery menu. Now, of course, all art, logos, and stuff like that, it's been done in HD, you know, not pseudo HD, but actually HD, as you can see here. I have this on my 4K monitor, and it looks absolutely beautiful. There is, like, no margin for error here. Very high quality art, so kudos again, guys. You guys did a great job. So let's say we go into one of the games. Let me show off how everything transitions into the game. Boom, there you have it. No edit, no nothing. As you can see, it has the night bezel. So it's nicely subdued. You know, really, really cool stuff. And you have the option of setting it up any way you want. Now, exiting the game, same deal. Start and select. Boom. There you have it. Right back at it. So, what else do we have here? Okay, as far as system goes, we have 11 consoles, which we have Nintendo, NES, we have GameCube. Thank you, guys. Wii, Wii U, 32X, Dreamcast, Genesis, Saturn, hell yeah, PlayStation, Super Nintendo, Nintendo 64. Now, many more systems are going to come to the build. Believe me, this is not the extent of, you know, the systems and games that are going to be available for it. Let's just say that this is like the piece of chocolate cake with the ice cream coming very, very soon. So stay tuned for that. Now let's see what other combination we can do here. So I can then, after I show you this real quick in real time, because I want to show you guys going through it. Now you have a controls menu right here in case you want to go back and look up to see, you know, what manages what. You can just do it right here. You can disable the animation. As you saw here, player one channel three with his Titan, he has themed his Titan before and given us the option between RoboCop and Predator that were very popular when he released that theme for Core. Now he has, you know, those two at a click of a button, and also he added Sonic. So let's go into the Predator one, because that's the one that I like the most. Though RoboCop is pretty badass too, but you have the option. And let's go back here. And this time around, let's pick, instead of Titan menu, let's go with Atlas menu. For our primary, as I like to call it, we're on the primary Atlas right here. And if we go back into settings, you see how the menu changes to Atlas. Even though it says Titan, it's all part of the family. Let me pick the settings again. And for our games menu, or secondary, let's do the beautiful video wall. So basically what I'm trying to show you guys here is detail. Detail, attention to detail is the biggest thing here, because not only this looks good, because it looks amazing, all the videos, again, redone. Signum had his hand in remaking, redoing a ton of these videos to make them look really good and really animated for you guys. So yeah, aside from the build looking gorgeous, it actually has context. Why? Because the actual games and emulators that are in here are running absolutely fantastic. They're set in a way that many of you, regardless of the setup that you have, you can mess around. And if you're like me, you can tweak around and replace things here and there. But the thing is that it doesn't get stale. You know, it's something that you enjoy using and not only just looking at it, so to speak. So my little mini rant there. So yeah, we have the Atlas. Let's go to another console. Actually, let's go into collections. Now on the collection side, You're going to have three collections from the outset. Ten collections. Oh my God. 10 collections that you're going to have, starting with Donkey Kong. You got Doom. You guys know that one. I covered it in the past. Amazing. Final Fantasy Collection. Thank you, Stainless. Mega Man Collection. Metroid. Hell yeah. Sonic Collection. Street Fighter Collection. Super Mario Collection. Turtles. Zelda. And we go back to the start. Now, if you want to take a look at the actual collection, taking the Legend of Zelda collection, let me let it run here for a second so you can see the video in the background. Looking fantastic. And of course, since I selected the video wall for the secondary, the game menu, here it is. And the different games that are part of that collection. All with their info, their logos. Beautiful, beautiful stuff. Now, in the computer side, for now, we have this, and here is where we're gonna come for all the PC games. And at the moment, I have a few classics, already classics from the indie side of things. I expect more packs to be added in the future. Not so distant future, because something tells me this is gonna burn pretty bright. Now, as far as my taste goes, you know that I got really hyped for Hyperspin Attraction on a track mode. I feel just as giddy. I'm not drawing comparisons because they are different front end. That's a track mode, and this is still retro FE. But I have to hand it to the guys. You guys basically managed to get me excited for retro FE again, because to be completely honest, I had put it already in the back burner in the past and really didn't have much hope. And this is pretty good. This is pretty, pretty good. And I know I'm going to get a lot of use out of it. So yeah, we got some classic indie titles here. And we go back. The one thing I haven't showed here, there's other stuff here as well, just handhelds, for example. On the handheld side, we have the classic Game Boy, Game Boy Advance, Game Boy Color, Game Gear, and PSP. Now again, let me go and launch one of these here. Let me see which one should I do. Let's launch Crisis Core. As you can see, everything is running as it's supposed to. And we go back to our type R. So yeah, guys, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to show you a little bit more to give you an idea or a taste for what other combinations of themes you can see here, themes and game menus and stuff. But it is completely awesome. If you haven't noticed by now, I'm completely going crazy over this stuff. So yeah, let's get into that and then I'll close the video up for you guys. So yeah, guys, that is going to be all for now. I hope you enjoy this kind of crazy showcase slash tutorial of Core Type R from the guys over there at the Core Discord. They got to be jumping for joy seeing that little baby put out. It's finally going to be released. So I hope you guys enjoy. Leave me a comment if there's anything else you would like me to see cover. I'm going to go back to playing this damn thing, and I hope you guys enjoy it just like I'm guessing that they wanted you to enjoy it since they started this nice little project. So take care, guys. Please like and subscribe, and I will catch you on the next one. Have fun. Please. Take care, guys.